This video is going to be about solving nonlinear inequalities. And I want to compare the method we're going to use with what we did when we had nonlinear systems of equations. So let's take a look at a nonlinear system first. You remember in the video about nonlinear systems of equations, I started out with these two equations, y equals x squared plus x minus 1, and y equals negative x plus 2. And what I did was, to solve it algebraically, I started out by taking the right side of each equation and setting those right sides equal to each other. Since they were both equal to y, they must be equal to equal to each other. Now, and then I solved this algebraically, and I went on from there. If instead of that problem, I had been given this, in other words, everything the same except that instead of an equal sign, I've got a less than or equal to sign. So in other words, what if I'd been given x squared plus x minus 1 is less than or equal to negative x plus 2? Well, the first thing to realize is there's only x's here. They're not asking me anything about y. So I could take this and I could solve it algebraically, but we can solve it graphically a whole lot faster. So let's take a look at the graph we had in the previous video when we talked about these two equations. So here's that graph. And if you put in a graphing calculator, what you're going to do is you're going to take your first equation and call that y sub 1 and say y sub 1 equals x squared plus x minus 1. And I put that in red here. So we end up with a red parabola. And then I have y squared equals negative x plus 2. And I put that in blue. And so we have this blue straight line. And here I've got the inequality that we're dealing with. X squared plus x minus 1 is less than or equal to negative x plus 2. Well, if it was an equality, if there was an equal sign here, I would know when these two sides are equal. That would be the points where my two graphs intersect. That would be at the point negative 3 comma 5 and 1 comma 1. But notice I don't care about the y values. All I want to know is what are the x values that make this both sides of this inequality the same? Well, and the x values would be negative 3 and 1. In other words, if I put a negative 3 into this inequality, everywhere where there's an x, I would find out that both sides were equal. And if I put a 1 into the inequality, everywhere where there's an x, I would find out that both sides are equal. So as far as the or equal to part is concerned, I know the answer. The question now is, when is x squared plus x minus 1 less than negative x plus 2? What that means is, for what values of x are the left side of this inequality? For what values of x will the left side of this inequality be less than the right side? Now, graphically, what that means is, for what values of x, in other words, the values I see on my x-axis, will the red parabola, that's the left side of the inequality, for what values of x will the red parabola be lower than? Will it be less than the blue line, the negative x plus 2 line? Well, those values of x are going to be between negative 3 and 1. So my solution to this inequality is going to be, in interval notation, it's going to be a square bracket, and then negative 3, comma 1, and another square bracket. Square brackets because I'm including negative 3 and 1 in my answer. Okay? Any number between negative 3 and 1 will make the left side of this inequality less than the right side. If I want to write that in inequality notation, I can write negative 3 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 1. In other words, x is anywhere between negative 3 and 1, or it might equal negative 3 or 1. And I can write that on a number line. I'll mark off where the 1 and the negative 3 are. I'll fill in a circle at both of those points. I'm filling it in because I want to include those points. And it's everywhere in between those two points as well. Okay, those, in other words, are the x values. The number line is an x-axis. Those are the x values that will make this red parabola, this quadratic expression, less than this blue line, this linear expression. Okay? Now, what if we had x squared plus x minus 1 is greater than negative x plus 2? Well, let's see what that means. That means I want to find all of the values of x that make this quadratic expression on the left have a greater value than the linear expression on the right. Or graphically, all the values of x that are going to make this red parabola higher up on the graph than the blue line. Well, everywhere from negative infinity up to, but not including negative 3, will do that. So I can go down from negative infinity up to, but not including negative 3. And then between negative 3 and 1, the parabola is actually less than the blue line. And then I can start again right after 1 and go up to infinity. Okay, and if I want to do that on a number line, I'll once again mark where my negative 3 is and my 1. I'm going to put in an open circle for both of them because we don't touch either one of those. And I'm going from negative 3 down to negative infinity, and I'm going up from 1 up to positive infinity. Okay, all the numbers in there on that number line, which should be actually all the numbers on my x-axis of my graph, which make the quadratic part, this red parabola, greater than, higher up than, the linear part, the blue line. Okay? And that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.